Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you possibilities of my free flow fight combat system, which I did. Okay, let's just start. This system is component based, as you can see here, and all these components has different settings that in combination give you the combat system itself. This combat implements a lot of features that probably will be necessary for you. Features as takedowns, as finishers, and many different. Also, this let me just show you how takedowns work. For example, if we just go on. Okay, I just forgot to say that this system also comes with the locomotion. And very performant locomotion, which is stat FPS, because stat unit, because I don't use any ticks or stuff like that. I'm using ticks only inside of the combat component during ragdoll and stuff like targeting, but in the most of the NPCs there are no ticks. So this all leads us to good performance on all your opponents, on all the NPCs. Also, this locomotion system that I did, it's component based, so your main combat character blueprint doesn't have any trash, doesn't have anything, as you can see. It doesn't have even functions. It's clear because everything of it is just inside components, inside locomotion component, combat component, and stuff like that. Our code is clear. You can just be sure about that, because I'm just commented everything. Of course, our comments is done properly and in the proper places. If I call something, I just write where I call it, why I do it, and stuff like that. So the each component also has the bindings about its state changes, so you can bind to them and just use this inside of your real game. This is just actually designed to be used as a real game part. So also it has just four directional jog. It's crouch, yes, just it's the crouch, and in crouch you can even sprint a bit. I just decided to make this type of animation because I never seen that any locomotion system implement that. I just give you additional animations. This system entirely, if we just check this one and go to the animations, has 181 animation item, which is huge amount. All these animations are made inside of the Blender by me, by hands. So yeah, I'm just kind of proud of it. First, I'm just done this locomotion, and only then, after I realized that I can do this, I did the combat itself. Okay, let's just focus on our possibilities in combat. We can start our combat by just taking down this our first opponent. If we come here, we can watch even we can take down him from the backwards once we are crouching. So. And this takedown will work even if we will look, for example, inside of this direction. Let me just press E and see, show you how exactly it works. It exactly meets with the animation that I did inside of the Blender. And the next one will be, you want to attack us, let's eliminate him. And do this again with this. This system has two takedowns like that. This was the finisher. Right now finishers are used to kind of randomly, they are triggered randomly from the stats when you just achieve some kind of hit point. Okay, where is it? Finishes. With some random chance, finisher is getting triggered, and there is setting that finisher hit point threshold that you can set inside of your character, and after that threshold, your hits can trigger finishers. So finishers are very kind of very interesting feature in here. Also, you have a lot of settings inside of the combat component. Let me just show you the combat component settings. Here you can see the attacks itself, combo montages. This is the main combo montages that are triggered from left mouse click. There are like first is the attack itself, and the second is impact. Impact is the animation that is getting triggered when you hit your this impact, this exact impact, this automatic impact getting triggered when you hit your enemy from the front. If you hit your enemy from the other side, like backwards or like something like that, it just not getting triggered. It in this case getting triggered impact montages. Here you have, you can specify from what body part you hit. Is it head, torso, hands, legs? And impact default direction is, do you hit from the forward, do you hit from the backward, and stuff like that. This one getting filtered and played. Like there are different montages for the armored and aimed characters. By armored and aimed, I of course tell you this position and these positions. Also, this system has arm and unarm animations, and also it's very suitable because in future I probably plan to use it with the sword animations. And it's completely accessible because it has arm, unarm, and stuff like that, and it's definitely can be played. So also this system has very interesting animation layering technique that I used. So you can arm during movement. Yeah, as you can see, you can even unarm during movement, and it will not trigger your legs to change. And you can, if you will arm by staying in the place, your legs position will change. And the same, you can kind of hit during movement. Player cannot, the NPCs can, because mostly NPCs attack you, not you. This system also has this smart layering, smart montage layering technique. You can watch how is it made from the system. Also, after the impact, let's just close it. It has three kicks. Let me show you. I just don't remember, do I say it about kicks or not? Okay, let's just arm first, and then just one, two, and three. These three kicks are very kind of common kicks that you can see. So I just made them. There is kick montages. You can snap them to a certain distance. This 100, it's in the centimeters. It's not in the meters, it's centimeters. 1 meter has 100 centimeters. And you can switch the layering. This is automatic layering. Of course, since we are triggered this kick animation for the legs, we don't have to layer it to the spine 03 because it's just for the legs. And hit type, kick, and hit side. These hit types are mostly important for the playing impacts and playing inside of the stats and applying damage to the character. If we go to the stats settings, there you can find this hit damages setting where you can specify exact damage for kick and for the punch. As you can see, it's all in here. Also, you can uncheck this is alive to make your kind of some of your NPC dead. Maybe you loaded it from the kind of from the save and you want him to be dead, so he is dead. And you can just use this for your purposes. Also, this system has very interesting functionality about combos, because it's kind of it has this play parallel montage in which you can just play montage on your character and or on your target. And actually that function is gives you unlimited possibilities of implementation, because simple, because if we take the simple way. For example, you can use it in cutscenes or during some game interaction, because different characters can interact with each other and they can kind of shake hands or do something like that. I don't know, like you can do this. You can use this system for a lot of purposes, including some like 18 plus purposes, 18 plus animations. I will not tell you what is it, but you probably understand how this can be used. But of course, these animations are this system is used by me to just trigger this parries. I made let me just fight with this one. Okay, this parry is triggered. And he just killed me. Okay, combat is complicated. You should be wary, because I played it a lot of time and I have a bit of reaction. You should know that they easily can defeat you. It's even if they are four of them, they can easily defeat you. It's not like easy combat system that you can probably expect from this one. It's not. They are hard to fight. They can defeat. So, yeah, I tried to make it mostly interesting, because it's just a real game system. And damage after parrying can be kind of... damage after parrying is applying randomly from 15 to 120, I think. So some of them after parry doesn't get down, they just stand up and just get away from us, and then just get returns, and then just they return to attack us. So okay. Also, this system has AI that force only two characters at once attack us from the first time. After, of course, this amount can be increased. If you hit them, for example, from the back, they will aggro to you, as you can expect. Okay, this one. If you kinda hit some more, this will be aggroed as well, like that. Okay, this is the everything, I think. And now this system will be published on the Unreal Engine Marketplace. Feel free to see it if you're interested. Hope that this system will find some auditory, some people that will purchase it, because I have plans to kind of improve it even better, to give bigger animation amount, some different parries. Of course, talking about parries, I just didn't shown you how they are look like. There are inside of the combat components setting for that purpose, kicks, parry montages, and there are inside of the parries. You can see that attack direction, snap direction, because when you just, for example, fire takedown, you have to snap to back, not to the side. Not you can snap back, forward, right, left, and stuff like that. But during takedown, you snap to back, and this character should face forward. So this is the what we just say. This forward takedown to the forward direction. It just play it like this, and you can control play rates. You can control distance to snap, of course, always, and stuff like that. You have three forward combos. You have three right combos. Two of them, because I don't have a much of imagination about making the takedowns from the sides. Two left combos, like left, and kinda two backward combos, and one of the backward combos is the kinda throw from back to forward. Also, you have this hit push montages. They are getting triggered. I also animated them. They are getting triggered when they getting triggered when you stay in the block. Like, as you can see, if you if player always blocks, it just getting triggered because enemy starts to kick him, and you just always getting pushed. Push animation triggered randomly, so it's all depends on the random. Also, if some enemy just gets behind you, it also can push you, also randomly. So there are four different directions: push, pushes backward, forward, and stuff like that. Also, it has this system has evasion system, evade montages. Evades triggered in old version. I just wanted to apply some evasion stat inside of the stats to your player, but then I realized that it is very, very bad design for the player, and I just get rid of it. But evasions still use it, and they use it by the NPCs. If you, for example, come here and attack him four times, and he just got evaded, you probably seen that. This is very interesting because it just creates some action to the fight. It just shows that your NPCs aren't just kinda robots or stuff like that. They are alive, they try to defend themselves. So here you have this evade B and different kinda in different directions evasions. Also, you have this hit reset montages. Hit resets are used when you parry your opponent, like, let me just, in exact time, like this. This was the hit reset. One, two. And after you kinda did it, one, two. It gives you a bit of pause to, kinda this was finisher. The after hit resets, you have takedowns, of course. This two takedowns here, from backwards, snap to backwards, of course, and finishers. Finishers are forward to forward. There are like finishers, and also like fall down. Fall downs are triggered when you kind of start to ragdoll, but you can control this. You can play fall down, you cannot. If you don't want to play fall down in some special situations, you can disable it. Here is just the boolean, it's just fully controllable. Our death, our like alive, die alive functions are inside of the stats component. So yeah, and probably I should say about animation blueprint, how is it looks like. Well, it's just pretty clean. I tried to make it very, very clean and very, very easy to access, very easy to understand. It's basically extended default locomotion from the Epics, and jumps are standard. I didn't animate jumps because this system is obviously not about the jumps, it's about the fight. This you have staggered, you have ragdoll state and stuff like that. Everything. Also, you have turn in place if you're interested in, then just your character turns. You don't have to make this because I already did it. And this is fully production ready, as you can understand. Of course, turns works for the armor, it's obvious, and stuff like that. As you can understand, 181 animation, kinda it's how utilized in here, so just letting you know that, and I don't ask for this system very big price, as you can understand, it's like $15. For $15 you can get only animations, 181 animation, and this is huge. Okay, I'm just sorry to say, but it's I don't know who can offer the better solution. I probably should delete this before release because we don't need it. And of course, rebuild the lights. Build lighting only. Let me just. I just added this to jump from it. It's not necessary for. Okay, probably I can stop recording this my tutorial right now. If you watch till this, thank you for your attention, and hope that you will like this system and you will support me, because right now I'm actually in huge trouble. And I'm in Russia, and Russia in huge trouble. Yeah, I'm just in the winter in the middle of nowhere sitting here. So I'm just hope that you will help me and we will help each other, because I can do better things, not only this one. I can do a lot of things. Unfortunately, man like me is not needed in this country anymore. So all what I have to do is just to survive. Okay, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, or at least just watch it this time. Goodbye.